My name is Bali Sidi Ahmed. I'm a Somali Bantu who was born in Somalia, but fled to a refugee camp named Hawadera in Kenya at the age of 5. One day, my dad, my sweet mother, my sister, my grandmother, and I were having a relaxed day in our house. I was 5 at that time, and everybody in my family had a special love for me because I was the first child for my parents to live so long. Suddenly, 3 Malaysian men who were not Somali Bantu stepped into our house. When those 3 men came to our house, everybody in the house was overcome with fear. My grandma started crying when they took my father outside. These 3 men stood with my father under the big tree called Heyday beside our house, asking my dad for money. In about a minute, one of them came back to the house in order to let us know that nobody should come outside of the house. At that point, my mother remained quiet like someone who had been ill for years. My grandmother could not stop the tears running down her cheeks because my father was her last and lovely son. A while later, my dad was tied to the big tree beside our house, and the men started to beat him with a very big stick and the backs of their guns. My dad started crying with the pain. My question to you is, how would you feel if your father was beaten in front of you? My father was crying, "Muslim Malik, Muslim Malik," which means, "Is there no one to help me? Is there no one to help me?" My mom and my grandmother were then taken outside to see my dad being beaten up. When I heard my dad's voice crying, I ran and stood at the door. Even though I was young, I was upset with the situation of my dad. When the sun was about to settle down, they took him away from us. The men tortured him in another house in our village for 3 days. Me and my mom went to where my dad was being held to beg for his life. They released him where they understood that my father did not have any money. But the way they beat him, he became so paralyzed he couldn't even take steps and was throwing up blood. When his death was almost near, he handed us over to our uncles who were leaving the village to go to a refugee camp. My father died. My sister and I became fatherless as we were fleeing the country with our uncles. Even today, in my vision, I see my father in a house and the big tree beside of our house. I'm sharing this story so that people understand what happened to thousands of Somali Bantu families in Somalia, and to also prevent this from happening again.